against Sporting Thistle last week is Drew Busby, the man from Canada. I saw him playing in the NESL for Toronto Blizzards during the summer, playing splendidly in midfield for them, and he'll add a great deal of strength in that area to the Greenock side. Rangers have had a lot of injury problems, and there were various fitness tests at Ibrox this morning. The most notable failure was Tom Forsyth. He didn't pass, he doesn't play today, but Colm McAdam notably does. He was injured, is recovered. He scored 8 with that head you just saw him using there in the league and the League Cup. And obviously a marvellous buy for Rangers. And the referee today is David Murdoch from Barbo. Morton kicking off on top of an immaculate pitch, and considering the rain we had yesterday, what a transformation in Cappielow. In days gone by, you would have had about a foot of mud here, but that's a quite splendid pitch transformation which took place during the summer. Jordan. McDonald turning on neatly. Look at that support inside there. 3 Rangers players just to the left of McDonald. Now Johnson. McLean picked it up. Rangers intent on keeping possession, which they barely did there. Johnson and all 3 Rangers players in an offside position as he came forward. Can be no complaints about that one. Redford. Haven't seen him really coming forward all that much for Rangers. This is the break now. 3 against 2. And Cooper still gets it. McDonald, he's gone offside. Great chance. There's no power behind it. And the direction suited the goalkeeper as well. Jordan again. There's McAdam's first touch of the head. And Andy Ritchie let that go, thinking he may take on Johnson, but wisely Johnson had about 4 or 5 yards for the back. Miller just wriggles free. No, puts his defense in problems. McNeil. Busby. Support there by Holmes. And McLean just in the way of that. The far side, Rooney. Corner kick. The big man to take it, there he is. Huge figure, Darren McCloy. That's it. It's been given. Busby. Drew Busby scores his first goal for Morton. Right on the spot to take that. 13 minutes of the first half gone, and when the ball floated across there, McCloy went for it. He may have been impeded, but certainly there was no great complaint about it, and the ball was hooked away by Busby. Jordan. Bit from McAdam. Well away though by McLaughlin. And this could be a good break. McNeil. Rooney was going down the middle, but he opts for Andy Ritchie. Holmes was supporting the left. Ritchie. And the free kick given that looked more like a stumble to me again. Ritchie and McNeil. This time McNeil trying to sneak it round and do it, Andy Ritchie, and doesn't even get pass marks for it. Oh, that's a bad blunder. Ritchie tries to touch it inside and almost goes a field. A penalty kick. It's a penalty kick. The referee had no hesitation in saying that McNeil was brought down there That came from that very bad blunder of the ball coming out of the Rangers' defence. Ritchie held it up, then sneaked it through. McNeil was brought down. Now, the penalty. 2-0. Andy Ritchie, the scorer. ...27 minutes of the first half gone. McDonald being proof. Quickly taken, McLean. Dive, the referee says, and McAdam looks as if he's on a long romp towards the referee again, but checks himself. Brilliantly brought down by McDonald, but he was fouled. There's McDonald, didn't quite know what it was, tries to wriggle through. Again a dive, there's no question about that, wasn't a penalty kick. Redford did get his head to it, but that's a good support work again by Busby. 8 minutes to half time, and that's a bad ball by Hayes. Rangers really up against it now. It's about now they should have been stung into some more positive retaliation just towards half time. Troubling ball again, McAdam. Turned on it well. Tries to go through the middle, there's Redford. Sandy Jardim. Johnston. And Miller will put it back to the keeper, and Rangers were on the attack there. And that is the way that Morton have been harassing and hampering Rangers, suffocating most of the moves forward. McAdam. Brought it down well, opens it up, Bet. Wants to take his man on and does us a beautiful chip across. Might be a bit strong, but the corner is conceded. Rangers lifting the game now. There's McAdam. Still in, and there's a penalty kick. A handling offence. Looked like McLaughlin to me. McLaughlin and Hayes were very close there. The hand went up. That was almost a scrimmage in a goal line. That's a penalty to Rangers. Well, what a confused situation that was, with so many players in for the corner kick, the ball bouncing about. And there, a furtive, but I think on the camera, clear hand penalty. Alec Miller to take it. That's it, 2-1. 39 minutes of the first half gone. McAdam just got the touch. Bet, superb. What solidity he's added to Rangers midfield this season. Bet doing the running on the right, and Redford was giving support. The ball angled too far away. Cooper trying to go around the outside, and he does. That's a good run. He wants to get it to his left, but what's this? Superb run, and there's nobody there. Well, the Rangers supporters are a bit annoyed about that final pass, but look at the way he bore down. Now, he took everybody with him, and where was the support? He ought to have had somebody coming in there. Now, the cutback was obvious. Cooper. Good save by Baines. Three minutes to have time. Game bubbling up again. Nice way to switch the play.
Well, that's to nobody. There's no offside. There were two players, two Rangers players on either side of the field in the wings, Cooper and McAdam, but nobody down the middle. Away. Ritchie. Thompson. Corcoran. Johnson is there, but only knocks it back. Hayes. Jackson. But sees winning that, but McGill there picks it up well. Oh, it's a good save. Just once or twice, Peter McCroy has plucked it out of the air like that, making it look ridiculously simple, which it isn't. Cooper. He does get the shot in his jump pass. He almost cheated up for himself. When Cooper goes like that, you never know what he's got to do. He's a very unpredictable player when he moves forward, but when it comes right for him, he's very spectacular, and it did there. That wasn't far away. Very high. McLean is underneath it. He doesn't usually head the ball. Tommy McLean, he is bent. Wants to beat the offside trap, and they do. McDonald can't get it. McAdam's there. On the outside, and just away. And Rangers really squandered that chance. Well, that sums it up, doesn't it? Anguish, frustration, and how did I miss it? Johnson. Smartly back by Jordan. McDonald's on the outside, and that's a throw. Well, the halftime whistle should go any second now. There haven't been many stoppages in the game. Referee looking at his watch. And there goes the halftime whistle. A very fine first 45 minutes, and so far, Stephanie Morton's day. I think crucial to the performance, Drew Busby coming back from American football and playing emphatically and constructively in midfield for Morton. There's no doubt about it that he provides a kind of solidity that perhaps have been badly needing in this opening part of the championship. And what do you make of a man who just comes up, always was a good goal snatcher, popping the ball away? And good to see Andy Ritchie, of course, at the same time. Now, Andy is not everybody's idea of a hard-working player, but he is an entertainer after all. It's the subtlety of him, the sheer charm that he has in his play at times, almost impudent. And for Rangers, I think Jim Bett has held them together very well in midfield. The great thing is the simplicity of his play. He doesn't get too fancy about it. Keeps them going, passes the ball around, and then just occasionally brings something surprising out. And Rangers trailing at the moment, but there's a lot in them yet. And really no way of telling how this game eventually will work its way out. Rangers coming very strongly back there in the latter part of the first half, but Morton playing some very good counter-attack football, in particular the first 20 minutes. That's McAdam trying to go around the outside there. Oh, a superb tackle, though. McLaughlin coming forward now. McLean. It's a long one and a good one. Baines just indicating not to be panicked by that shot. He got right behind it. Well, he neatly put down McNeil. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Neatly touched forward there by Thompson. Right into the path of McNeil. Ritchie was a bit of pirouetting, and he still has it. A good looking ball. Thompson's behind it. Good tackle though by Johnston, who is right on the spot. Gets applause from his goalkeeper, Peter McCloy. Johnston's played well today. Thompson's there, so is Cooper, and the free kick is given. Broad smile in Thompson's face, taking all that treatment lightly. Good one swung in, and McAdam back defending. Good ball by Johnston, it opens it out. Bett is going forward in a brilliant run. Bett for Rangers. He's taken wide and it's almost there, and it's ducked beyond McLean. It was a great save. Bayes did extremely well, and that's one of the most intelligent moves in the game. From Rangers defence, that neat little ball by Johnston, and look at the superb running by Bett. Great vision. But he was taken away wide and he swept it across. Bayes did well to get the touch. McLean a bit unlucky, came in too far. There goes McDonald. Dora's there, and that's the corner kick. Rangers with infinitely more threat in the second half. Once again, McLean. Once again, the curl, Baines. This is McLean. That's a chip. Oh, Jackson was in a better position. Beautifully judged chip there as it went right across. There were two men there. And you could see that Colin Jackson was further behind the ball, could have come in on it. And it slid away from the top of McAdam. Well picked up by Redford. He can't go forward with it though. Derek Johnson's positioning today has been quite without fault. McAdam, McLaughlin with him. Curls it round neatly. Jardine. Now Cooper. It's curling and it's nowhere near any blue jersey. Jackson, and that ball's still in play. Well, Jardine did well. Still there, now Cooper. A great save again by Bates. Now he needed to beat that down first. He simply got in the line of it, showed the resistance, and then gathered it up on the rebound. Good ball to the inside, and Redford mops it up as Rooney goes forward. Now Johnston. There goes Miller. Still Miller. It's a spare man. And Miller again with a chance. Can't get a shot in. McAdam. Much too obvious, and anyway, Cooper was in an offside position. Bit laborious in the build-up. Miller certainly looked good when he went through on the left, but could bring it down, not incisive enough. Jackson did well to put that back. That's meant for Willie Johnston. Swept it right up. Here's McKenna with it. Oh, that's hooked away from Cooper. Beautiful move by Rangers. Nudged away by Busby. What a valuable game he's played. Stevens was in, and the referee thinks it was late and siding. Free kick. Right through the middle of that defence. Get nowhere near it. Rangers can't clear that ball though. Ritchie. That's almost an own goal. Colin Jackson sorely troubled by that. Difficult one. It was between himself and the goalkeeper. Beautifully flighted in there by Ritchie. Jackson just got his head in the way. Well, that's one under the boot from Andy Ritchie. Not quite sure what that was meant to be. I'll ask him about that afterwards. Gregor Stevens in a way by Jackson. Brilliantly. Vett can't get it. Does it the second effort. McLean gives up on that. That's Jardine. Johnston can't get it. McAdam going down and swept beautifully away by McLaughlin. What a marvellous match the big centre has had. Long-legged. Proved valuable today for him. Miller. Going away left. That's Johnston with a great save. Perhaps a save of the match. A great ball across by Miller, and all Johnson, Willie Johnson did was deflect it with his head, and the goalkeeper had to leap away and get it. There's Jackson. Hayes is after it. Beautifully turned by Tommy. And that's a brilliant ball. Cochran. Oh no, he wasted that. He had players coming up in support. They have got a brief glimpse of a screaming Thompson there. I didn't enjoy that finish one little bit. Johnson was there, but picked up by Renino Redford down. 2 minutes to go. Here's McLean. Referee does stop the play. Free kick. McLean with it. It's a good looking ball. It's there. McAdam has done it. The equaliser with only about a minute and a half left. And that must be one of the most valuable pieces of property in the game. Colin McAdam's head. There it was again. Simplicity itself. The floated ball. The timing. And beating it so beautifully there. And a brilliant goalkeeper like Baines with no chance. McAdam again. Back to McLean. It's away wide towards Derek Johnston. Here's McAdam and couldn't quite get his shot in. Bent right out of the park, right out of the ground. Redford did get there. Willie Johnston. Referee says it's a throw to Morton. And there goes the final whistle. Really remarkable game, and all credit to Morton, who were not considered to have a chance this afternoon, not only for taking the initiative but leading Rangers for so long, and they must really be terribly frustrated at the thought that that equaliser came so late in the match. But then again, that is the threat that McAdam poses.